daydream, smoking on some OG. Well, I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on my love.
All right, y'all, so we're gonna be doing some planning for Round Top. And for all of you that don't know what Round Top is a big antique outdoor market in South Texas. Antique dealers from all around the world like go there and they're there dealing, selling to other antique vendors, all kinds of stuff. There's a ton of vendors there. It lasts 2 weeks long and we're going for what, 4 days?
Yes.
We're going after like certain pieces for sure. Like, oh, we for sure want a dresser for our bedroom and, you know, different pieces like that. I think we want to get a bed for one of the guest bedrooms. We kind of have an idea to go after like more of like an antique vintage bed for one of the guest bedrooms. So what we're doing here now is we're going to prioritize like the things we're going after and things we're wanting that we for sure are looking for.
Yeah.
And then we're also taking pictures of each room. And right now, Julia's just like printing off the pictures. And then we're going to measure each space and draw the measurement on in that room of like, or on the picture itself.
Yeah.
Just to get an idea, so when we're there at Round Top, we'll have like a notebook of pictures and the measurements of each space in the room. And so we want to be very specific with what we're choosing.
I know.
And we feel this will be the most organized way.
Need to have your measurements. Okay.
So real quick, what are the 10 pieces that are the priorities? And if we can, list them in order.
Nightstands for sure.
Okay.
Probably like my number one. And dresser, master bedroom. Chairs for living room, yeah, if we find them. So we're not gonna force it, but if we find them.
Gonna do coffee table for a living room?
Yes, coffee table and then side table. Now, the piece that I got that's in my office, the buffet piece, I am in love with it, but I just don't think it's the right size. It's gonna go upstairs, and I have the perfect spot for it upstairs. So that's why I bought it, because I knew it would either go there, if I couldn't make it work in my office.
So you want to buy another?
I want to get like just a bigger version of that, basically.
That fits in the window?
Yes.
Like because, from wall to wall?
Mm-hmm. I think it just looks like weird.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm looking for that. And possibly chairs for my office. Like if there's some things I can get. Buffet for Julia's office.
I'm looking for just potentially this isn't a requirement, but just a... If I find the right piece, I'll buy it.
Yeah.
A desk for my office.
Okay, yeah.
Because I think for the office size, my desk is too big.
Yes.
And it's not the right material for in there.
I agree.
I have like big wood shelves like that. I feel like it kind of is more traditional.
It is. And I don't know. Desk. That's just not...
Something about the desk in there isn't working. So buffet for your office. Chairs for your office, possibly.
Yeah.
I've really been
struggling with my office furniture. Like, I have the vision in my head, but it's just like not coming together.
Do you want to keep an eye out for a desk for your office?
Possibly, but if I get the buffet side table, I don't want like two wooden pieces. So I'm definitely like open to like literally doing my whole office there if we can find it. But if not, you know, we'll see.
Okay.
Okay.
For the room that we're gonna maybe the guest bedroom. Oh, a bed for the guest bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
For the small one, right? We're gonna do it in the small one.
Yeah, except I wanted to kind of...
Well, because that room...
Either one, there's two bedrooms.
But that, remember we decided that room, because the bathroom's more of like a cottage bathroom.
I know.
Sloped and slanted.
I think that's the right one to do it for. Okay, so then this is what I want to do.
The piece for the bathroom?
Yeah, I need the piece for the bathroom. I want to put the beige bed that's in the main master, or the main guest bedroom right now.
What, say that again?
The beige bed that we have up there.
Up in the
I want to move that to the middle room.
Sure.
And I have the nightstands from Walmart that are going to go there, and I want to style the whole thing. Okay, that'll be that room. Then we'll get the vintage bed for the smaller one.
Okay.
And then I want to get the blue charcoal linen bed that I showed you. I want to do that vision in the main guest bedroom.
Where was that from?
I showed you a while back, but I'll show you. It was kind of like when we first moved in. But I think for the main guest bedroom, it's just so big that it needs like a bigger bed, and it needs to be more of like a situation.
No, I also think because that room is so tall.
Yeah.
And big, we could do a canopy bed in there. And it could look really good.
I thought about that. I definitely thought about that too. But I think it's definitely something we could get new. You know, like, I don't think that that's going to be a vintage piece per se. Oh, I wanted to do this vibe in there. It'd be like the only room that we have, like, a... Still neutral, but...
Yeah, I think we go new canopy bed.
Yeah, just like, for variety.
Like, think about the ones from Restoration Hardware where it's not just the canopy, but it's, like, the headboard is, like, behind the night. Like, go big in there, because totally. It's big.
Okay, I like that. Yeah, I think that's not something we get at Round Top.
No, totally.
Okay.
And that's not at Round Top either. I just mean, like...
No, I know.
But... Okay, so deal. Let's think... Okay.
Deal.
So, the room we're going to get the bed in, should we look for antique nightstand? Should we go full antique in that room? And, like, be our one room that's, like...
Probably. I think we, yeah, keep... Like, basically, we're looking for, like, a bedroom, guest bedroom set. Not, it isn't, they're not a set, sorry, like,
no,
but,
totally.
Like, a whole thing, yeah.
Like, nightstands, and possibly a dresser. Here's the thing with guest bedrooms, you really need dressers. They never get used.
No. The closet is fine. Okay. The next thing is a bench for the entryway. I want with a tall back.
For this entryway?
Yeah. Oh, vintage mirror. I really want a vintage mirror for...
up there.
That landing on the stairs.
Case. Yeah. What do you want to do there? Because it's not that wide. We can't really put a table there.
I just want to put a mirror.
So just get a big mirror?
Yeah, and what? Maybe my... I ordered this little Spanish stool chair from Etsy. It's like vintage. It's really small. I'm going to put it just in the corner with a little blanket, and then I want to put the mirror.
I think it.
Professional bad decision maker. Yeah, I'm a professional bad decision maker.
Okay, we are measuring all the spaces in our bathroom. Just to show you what we were talking about earlier, we have the rooms printed out, and then we are measuring different spots just to, like, have, if we ever find pieces while we're there, we know exactly how big each spot is for potential pieces. So Julie just measured that spot right there for potential item. Maybe like a bench for like some towels or something.
Yeah, just like an aesthetic one, but it could be cute. 36, just, I mean, it doesn't matter, but I don't think anything that high. Okay. I almost feel like we need to do two separate rugs in here. Like, the runner almost doesn't look right, don't you think?
Should we just go ahead and measure like the room until we know? Like,
just so we know, yeah.
I think the length is perfect.
Want some more room so we can like tuck in the furniture a little bit. I think if it's the length, okay, maybe the length.
Like, I think the length is good, and then you just have this like be like
a little wider.
It's like 4 feet. What is this? 5 feet? Is this, oh, 6 feet. It's 76 inches.
Well, then should we just keep this one and get like some ottomans on the side or like a bench?
That could be kind of cool. I think, though, this kind of takes away from what we're doing here.
That's what I think. Okay, how big was it?
The current coffee table?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is, okay, this is...
I think you want at least...
18 inches. And so what I'm saying is, I think it kind of, like, makes sense to have it the same amount of room on the two couch sides.
Yeah, why don't we just call it, like, 2-ish feet? With this, that's too far.
That's too far. Yeah, that's what I meant.
My feet on it.
It's... just over 2 feet.
Okay, so you definitely want
18
like,
inches.
18 inches.
And
but
so
we can always move the furniture in is what I'm saying.
I know, but what I was thinking though is we measure 18 inches from wherever we think our couch will be.
Yeah.
Start there and then measure where 18 inches is from this where the chairs will be. And we know how big we have to work with.
Well, but the thing is that the furniture is flexible. We can just move it in or out depending on how big the table is.
I know, but we haven't bought a coffee table yet, so the purchasing of a coffee table is flexible also.
I know. I think that if we know that it needs to be this general size, though, then we have, like, buffers.
That's why I'm measuring the general size. Where we think our couches will be. It's like measuring a wall. It's like, how big can we go?
I don't think we go any bigger than this, though, is what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay. So, this is exactly 18 inches. So, this is perfect.
Okay.
So, I think 76 inches is perfect.
Okay.
But now I'm measuring 18 inches from here.
Yeah.
So, this is 18 inches from where the couch is,
okay.
Right here. And
yeah.
So how far do you think of
the length? So I don't want it like any bigger than that.
4 feet.
Standing still is perfect. Yeah, I love a mellow moment. Reveling it. Reveling it. Silence here is golden. You'll get on another level with it. You'll get better with it.
Okay, it is lunch. I'm starving. It's actually 2:20, and I feel like we've just been back to back to back all morning. So I'm popping in a little freshly fit meal into the microwave. 3 minutes. Don't got time for nothing else. And I and yeah, so I'm gonna eat that in a second. And then we finally need to get to work. The house cleaners are here, so cleaning up. Just so happens they're coming the day before we leave, but it's probably gonna get really messy if we don't have them just like, you know, come today. So we didn't want to skip it or anything. Okay, now it's time to eat lunch. Get to some computer work. By the way, changed our workout to 6:30. I don't think we ever said that because we were like, oh, wake up and we're going to work out, but we ended up changing it because we got the walk up super late, and yeah, so anyhow. That's the dealio. Fast forward, it is 6 o'clock. We are going to our 6:30 workout. We're both so excited. We had the busiest day. You know, when you have like a really busy, kind of stressful work day, you just want to exert some energy and like have a little self-care. That's what we consider our workouts. Kind of like an unwind when you do it at the end of the day, at least. So that's where we're headed right now. Yeah, we have to stop at UPS. So yeah, we're on our way right now.
We're on our way to the workout, doing another 6:30 workout, and it's 6:10 precisely.
It might be on the way.
And it is on the way. And we got some boxes we gotta drop off as returns.
The shoe returns.
Yes.
And if I don't return them now, I mean, we're gonna be gone for like 10 days, so I might miss the return window. So, and our workout's at 6:30 to 7:30, and the UPS closes at 7, so.
So we gotta do it now. Happen. Now we're. When we get back, and let's try to do it now if we can. All right, got the UPS dropped off, and it's only 6:13. 3 minutes later, that's golden.
That literally was only like about 2 minute deviation from the. We're still gonna be early.
Yeah,
it's crazy. The other class is probably just getting out, actually.
Yeah.
I think we should almost just pick up something on the way home from the gym because, and we just eat while we finish up, and then just yeah, maybe.
Or do you want to do Martin's again?
Yeah, Martin's is so good. So good, huh?
We can do Martin's like salads again.
Yeah, with the wings, so good. Okay, we're gonna find parking and here we go, cardio day. What a day. That's busy.
Finding your soul's flight. That's why it's nice when I'm inside. I like when I'm inside. Our souls coincide. Our goals coincide. Looking for a finish. We don't force those lines. We was more exciting than fucking in the bed. And look at you, were so inviting. Love my presence, found my mellow frightening. Like hello fellow precious pretty life. Lay down on my pillow every night. Put your passion on me every night. Put your passion on me every night. I can stay up with you every night. You don't ever press up any nights. I like everything you said we like. We could be like Lisa Lenny, right? Like hello fellow precious pretty life. Lay down on my pillow every night. Put your passion on me every night. Put your passion on me every night.
Wow.
Yeah.
So dizzy.
Yeah. I'm hungry too.
That was the first time in a long time that I felt like I was gonna like get like sick during the workout.
Really?
It was all like the burpees and stuff.
Oh, a lot of like up and down.
You know, we should start doing again when we get our treadmill is tread through. So good. That's interval training too.
Okay, we are home. We got some salads delivered from Martin's and a side of fries and some chicken wings. We usually just split the salad because it's a good size. And I shared this on Instagram. I think I basically put this on like literally everything that goes into my body, but it's fine. The everything but the bagel seasoning on the salad. Next level. You wouldn't think to put it in a salad, but it like, it makes it so good, like salty and like oniony. It's like almost, you could put like a really boring dressing and then just put the seasoning and it's amazing. So we're gonna eat and honestly, we have so much to do. We are still, it is 8 o'clock. We still have to get the vlog up. I have to thumbnail it, link everything for you guys. And then we have to pack for our trip. I have to shower. So we might have to pick up the camera again. So if that's the case, thank you guys so much for watching. And we'll see you tomorrow for a little travel day. And we're gonna be in Round Top. It's just gonna be a really fun experience. So we'll share all about that later, but peace.
Yeah, body built for the beach. Do you got that ocean? Body surf, don't sleep. Your body surf on me.